Hello friends, welcome to Tutorial Point. In this video we will cover exec statement. Now this is the agenda. We will cover why exec statement is required in the description, then we'll see the syntax of exec statement, and then we'll see what are the positional parameters and keyword parameters used in exec statement. Now why exec statement is required? Exec statement, we specify the program name or the procedure name. Here the program, like the program you want to execute, suppose you want to execute program A, then you need to mention the program name here in the exec statement. Then a job can have maximum 255 exec statement. Also one exec statement is required for a job because you need to mention a program. Without a program there is no point of coding a job. Then this is the syntax, these are the identifier, then here you need to mention any name, 8 characters. Then the exec, this is the keyword you need to mention, like for job we had job, for exec we need to write exec. Then we have positional parameters and keyword parameters. So we have two positional parameters, one is PGM, that is program, then one is procedure. In program we have discussed, we need to write the program name here, and in procedure we need to write the procedure. So procedures we will be covering in the coming videos. So procedures are also like program only, but they are defined. It can be in stream or it can be outstream. Then these are the keyword parameters. We have accounting, condition, region, time and palm. Here you can see condition, region and time. In job also we can code them, but at the step level also they can be done. Like accounting, if you want a particular step to be billed against any another bill number, then we can mention accounting for that particular step. All these will be valid only for that step only. Then we have condition. It takes the reference from the output of the previous steps. Like if the previous step executed successfully and it gave a status code 0. Now we can check that status code and we can put a condition here. Like if the condition is 0, then only this step will be executed. Then we can put condition there as well. Then we have region parameter. Region, like how much space should be given for that step to be executed. Similarly for time as well. Like only for that step how much time should be allocated. Then we have palm. Here we can pass values to COBOL program using palm. Suppose if a program is expecting a date or expecting time or any input from the user, then that can be given in the palm parameter. We have keyword parameters accounting, condition, region, time and palm. So now we'll see these functions practically.
We will see how to code an exec statement and the different parameters. I'm opening a PDF. Reset. At least one exec statement should be there for a single job. So this is our exec statement. So you need to specify the step name. We'll come after some time on these three steps. So we'll start from this statement, 530 line. So this is the step name. It can be of maximum 8 characters and you can specify any step. When you will see this pool, there you can identify from the step name. Then we have the keyword exec, and then we have positional and keyword parameters. So we have two positional parameters. One is PGM and one is PROC. So PGM is used to specify an program and PROC is used to call a procedure. So I will brief you a bit about JCL procedures. So JCL procedures are set of statements inside a JCL grouped together to perform a particular function. So usually they are the fixed part of the JCL. So if we and we can call it from any of the JCL. Suppose if we want to include it in this JCL, then we'll call the procedure, and when the job is executed, so it will add the steps mentioned in the procedure. We'll go in detail in procedure in coming videos. So now we'll start with the positional parameters. So as mentioned, we can, this is the syntax, step name, exec, PGM, then here you need to write the program name. Like here we have written program 1, we are calling program 1. So this is used to execute a program. So the second case is the procedure, and here the syntax is same. Instead of PGM, you need to write proc and you need to write the proc name. Also, you can call, you can directly call a procedure name. No need to mention proc. Simply mention step name, exec, and directly the proc name. So, these are the three cases for positional parameters. Then we have keyword parameters. So, we'll start with accounting. So, to override the parameters mentioned in the job statement, so this is used to supply accounting information at step level. Suppose this step, this should be billed to some other billing code. So, then we can override the job parameters, job accounting parameters, and we can mention it here at the exec level, step level basically. Then we have PALM. So, it is used to pass parameters, pass values to a COBOL program. Suppose we are passing a value welcome to the module program 1. Here this is the COBOL program and this is the parameter we are passing. Then we have time. So, it is used to override the default execution time. So, to give the maximum time, we can use 1440, or you can mention maximum or no limit, or you can mention in minutes and seconds also, like time is equal to minutes, like 3 minutes or some seconds. So, we can do that also. Then we have region. So, this is the common parameter, like this accounting is also a common parameter, region. So, to override the default amount of allocated memory, we can code region at step level also. Then we have condition. So, condition is used to execute steps based on certain conditions we mention. Suppose if the return code of previous step is 0 or it's a non-zero, then we can set conditions to execute the next steps based on the previous step. And similarly, we have if else. So, this can be used with the return code of the previous step. So, this is all about exec statement. In the next video, we'll focus mainly on condition and if else. So, we'll see the different scenarios and how to code a condition at step level and at the job level also.